In mid-February 2018, the Jim Henson Company partnered up with Fathom Events to re-release the 1982 film The Dark Crystal back in theaters for a short, limited run. This limited run saw the film returning to theaters for a total of 6 times, 5 during the 7 p.m. time slot, and the last screening being shown on a Sunday at 2 p.m. I made sure to attend as many screenings as possible, because I genuinely love this film. It's one of the greatest films of all time. Much like the exclusive slideshow that we went over previously on the channel, the audience was treated with a small documentary and a special introduction to the film. And much like the slideshow, I thought it was important to document this just in case you didn't get to see the re-release of The Dark Crystal in theaters, which means that you didn't get to see this mini-documentary as well. So without further ado, here is the mini-documentary and the introduction that was released with The Dark Crystal once it came back to theaters in 2018.
He had this sort of special fantasy project. He wanted to do something different. He was kind of a restless artistic spirit who would get something right and then immediately want to move to the next thing. Different technology, different advancement of the art form.
My Lord Chamberlain, it's time to choose an emperor.
He had the idea of doing an all-puppet fantasy world with no human beings and to utilize state-of-the-art puppetry and create an entire world. Neither Jim or Frank had directed a movie, but they were longtime collaborators and they just worked so well together. Their strengths as performers and as creators and makers, they really complemented each other. Frank is a meticulous and a perfectionist. Jim had a lot of wild ideas that he just wanted to get it to happen, and it was important that they were both directing because they were also both performing in the movie. They could not see very well, you know, when they were in their contorted positions. So certainly it was practical for both of them to direct, but they also complemented each other creatively and they were just a fantastic team.
I'll help you out.
The Dark Crystal is a masterpiece of puppetry, not only because it's a movie that is all puppets, but all those animatronic and puppetry techniques were brand new. So what we now call a creature effect, this hadn't really been done before. So these characters were going to be lit like they were real in the real world. So all materials were different from typical Muppet puppetry, and the animatronics and the cable controls and the radio controls, all without green screen compositing, without wire removal, without CG, they managed to hide every puppeteer, hide every control, do everything on set. And what it required was an incredible number of puppeteers. So, you know, you look at the behind the scenes shot, you can't believe how many puppeteers are on one Skeksis. So it was an amazing piece of technology and innovation and creativity in a way that probably would never happen exactly the same again. Well, when my father was making the movie, he was personally totally convinced that it was going to work. Whether the audience would accept a movie that didn't have humans in it was really still a gamble until the film came out. My father was really happy with what he put together, and the first screening of it was a disaster. The story was unintelligible, partially because the characters were largely unintelligible. Aside from the Gelfling, none of the other characters were speaking English. There was a lot of mime and gibberish of characters speaking made-up languages, and the audience just didn't understand it. I think Jim was convinced and Frank was convinced that people would understand what was happening in the scene without words, but they didn't. So in post, Jim and David O'Dell had to go through the whole movie and create new dialogue that would fit into the mouths.
You fraud!
At that point, it was becoming very questionable whether the movie would work and whether it would be accepted. And then when it came out, actually, it did pretty well. It has held up over time because it's now a real classic film of enduring importance. The film's 35 years old, and nobody has done anything like it since. Even though it was just one movie, it felt like a world that had centuries of history before it, centuries of future ahead of it. My father had an eye to include all of us in what he was doing, so he was incredibly open and sharing creatively. People say it was his vision, but it wasn't just his vision, because The Dark Crystal is a lot of Brian Froud's vision, and it is also an expression of Frank Oz. It wasn't important for Jim for it to be just his personal statement. He was creating a whole world, so he had a world of creators do it with him. Hi, I'm Lisa Henson, the CEO of the Jim Henson Company, and I want to welcome you to this special presentation. This film really represents the best of my father's work and that of his company and his collaborators. From the imagination, the creativity, the vivid storytelling, along with the technical expertise and the development of the craft that was required to bring this film to life, handmade in every frame, this film has become a true classic. With passion from fans like you, the film has endured over the years. So thank you for coming, and I hope you enjoy the presentation.
And as always, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to drop a like. If you would like to see more Dark Crystal content like this, consider subscribing here on the channel, and be sure to hit the bell icon so you never miss an update. Be sure to share this video with anyone you know that enjoys The Dark Crystal. And be sure to let me know your thoughts and concerns in the comments below.